Welcome, my children. Today we gather to pay our respects to St. Patrick, who brought Christ upon the great nation of Ireland. Please, go forth into this night with him in your heart as you chug your half-priced Guinness. Remember his strength as you hook up with that sloppy stranger with the clover pasties. And children, let his faith flow through you as you sing that one Dropkick Murphys song that everybody knows over and over again.
If green beer, dated stereotypes, and Jesus aren't really your thing, then here are some truly metal Irish heroes for you to raise your glass to this St. Paddy's Day. If there's one place on Earth humans should never be ever, it's Antarctica. 200 mile per hour winds, temperatures dropping below negative 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and nothing much but cold rocks and ice for 5.4 million square miles. But hey, if you're a masochist with an itch for adventure inside your shorts, like Irishman Ernest Shackleton, then you raise your middle finger to that fragile flesh pile you call a body and set out for fame and glory. In 1914, Shackleton and his crew decided to be the first to cross Antarctica from one end to the other by boat, because fuck it. But after 5 months, their ship, the Endurance, was crushed in an ice floe. For 8 months after, Shackleton and his men were trapped through the Arctic winter on their ship until it finally sunk. But hey, it's not so bad. After a couple months of walking, the ice beneath their feet broke in half, and they had to spend 5 days in lifeboats before they reached more uninhabitable shitty land. After that, Shackleton set out for help with a few men in a tiny lifeboat for 14 days in the icy seas towards South Georgia Island. But of course, even that would be too easy, because Ernest reached the island only to realize he was on the wrong fucking side. Man, it sucks to be this guy. He spent the next 36 hours becoming the first man to climb the 4,500-foot mountain range that was on the island, where he was able to find civilization and get a ship back to his crew. So somehow this guy managed to turn a catastrophic failure into an accidental feat of human strength and saved every one of his crew members. Talk about the luck of the Irish, right? Or how about the 16th century pirate queen of Ireland, Grace O'Malley, who learned to sail at a young age working for her chieftain father's shipping business. When she was 16, she was married off to the son of the chief next door, but after many dull years of playing housewife and robbing ships that came to her castle, her loving husband was killed in battle. Bonnie didn't waste any time getting revenge, though. She immediately faced off with his killers and took over Cock Castle, which she then renamed Hen Castle. Hashtag feminism. Ah, you guys love that stuff. Because she was such a badass, her father gave her his entire shipping and trading business when he died, and many ships along with it. And although she couldn't be the official chieftain of her clan because she had big ol' swinging titties, everyone treated her like she was because no one was trying to fuck with the pirate queen. Once a man-swine lord tried to insult her ladiness, so she kidnapped his grandson and demanded not money for ransom, but an open gate and a seat at the lord's dinner table for any stranger who happened to go into his domain. A deal, by the way, that still stands today. Grace spent her entire life plundering ships and kicking ass. It's told that she didn't give up her pirate ways until she was 70 years old. That's a cool grandma. Viking kin may claim to be the most metal people to ever inhabit the earth, but this Irish folk hero may take the title on his own. Ulf the Quarrelsome, yes, that's right, his name is literally Wolf Who Fights a Lot, appears only briefly in history and was described by his enemies as the greatest champion and warrior. The legend of Ulf and his king brother, Brian Boru, who ruled Ireland in the 11th century, is found in the Icelandic Njáls saga. During the Battle of Clontarf in 1014, Ulf and his brother faced off with the Viking Brodir of Man, who was himself very metal and described as most skilled in sorcery and as wearing armor which no steel can bite. Fuck. But it's also told that Brodir tucked his long hair into his belt, which is kinda lame. But we get it, when you have that kind of mane, you gotta keep it tight. When Ulf and Brodir first met on the battlefield, things did not turn out well for the Viking. After a failed attempt from Brodir, Ulf knocked the shit out of Brodir with his battle axe. When Brodir tried to get up, Ulf axed him again. Boom! Unable to take the shame of being less metal, Brodir retreated, like a bitch. That night, Brodir tried to redeem his metal cred to his Viking friends by savagely beheading Ulf's brother while he slept. When Ulf discovered the headless corpse of his brother, he went full berserker and probably yelled something like, "I will taste Viking blood tonight!" Ulf immediately set off to find Brodir, which was probably easy because you can smell a bitch from a mile away. When he found him, Ulf did possibly one of the most savage finishing moves in history. Here's the original quote. "Ulf the Quarrelsome cut open his belly and led him round and round the trunk of a tree, and so wound all his entrails out of him, and he did not die before they were all drawn out of him." So that's all we have for you today, dudes. Did we miss any Irish heroes? Let us know in the comments. Also, let me know what your favorite Irish metal bands are. And special thanks to my friend Brett for joining us today. You can follow him on Twitter here. And thank you for watching.